OutPower. Hello everyone, welcome to another OutPower tutorial. Today we'll be talking about some tips and tricks on how to use SQL directly within OutSystems. We'll be going over on how to use inserts, updates, and deletes directly within OutSystems and, with the right amount of care, even use them to replace entire flows. So, without further ado, let's get to it. Let's start off with the insert statement. We shall use a SQL query and set up its output structure. Now, in this type of statement, the output structure is not of much importance because we are not expecting to use its output. Let's use this output structure result, which has a value, text, and that's it, simple. Now that we are ready, let's write our statement. Okay, our insert statement is ready. When doing this, one thing we need to be aware of is if we set a comment at the end of the statement and test, although we could get an error, the statement will be executed and the data will be committed to the table. To prove this, let's just view the data as it is. Employee sale. Okay, our last record is ID 89. Commit. So we'll create a record for ID 8, 711 cold brew, 599. We test. We get an error. Okay, let's verify the data again. As you can see, a new one has been added, ID 90 for employee 8, the 711 cold brew. Okay, now that we've seen this using the test, let's just change our string a bit. Let's change it for the employee 10, and let's just call it cold brew. And execute this from a button on a page. I'll quickly create the screen for us. Okay, just finished creating this screen. We have a button, test insert, that takes us to our action with the SQL of the insert. And here is our insert statement. For the ID 10, product cold brew for $6.99. No commit, click done, and we debug. Okay, debug is ready. We open the page, test insert. Here is our debug. Let's do a step. As you can see, no error. Let's just verify the output. As you can see, no relevant information in the output. Okay, seems all good. F9 continue. Let's check our data one last time. View data. And here is our newly created record with success. Okay, we've covered insert. Now for the update. Let's set up a new SQL query in a similar manner. Our objective for the update is to set all of our employee records to active. Currently, I know that we have a couple of them that are not active. Let's just verify that. Here we go, our two records that are not active. Let's change our current statement into an update statement so that we can update all the records in one go. The same way as the insert, if we put a commit, we might get an error, but the data will be persisted into the table. There we go, we get our error. Let's check our data now. View data. Let's filter. There you go. As we can see, all the records are active now. This is an interesting pattern for when you want to update several rules in one go. So instead of using something like this, where you first get the data that you need, followed by a for each, and inside the for each then you update your record, you can use this method. Just be sure to update the records that are meant to. Our last statement for today will be the delete. So let's do as we have been doing so far. Let's grab a SQL query and set up the output. For this example, we're going to delete a specific record from the employee sales. First, let's do a query to find our record. Again, always be very careful with these statements. If they are used incorrectly, they can have a very big impact in our data. Here it is. Now we're going to write the statement to delete this record. Okay, our statement should look like this. Now let's execute this by pressing a button, and after that we'll verify the data. Okay, the screen is ready. As you can see, the statement is also here. Everything is ready to go. Let's run and test our statement. Let's execute. On to the debug. Step. As you can see, our SQL statement was executed without giving us an error. In similar fashion, the output doesn't have any relevant information. As you can see, there are no products, which the product name is just cold brew, nor the ID 91. And our last ID is the 91. And that is all for a quick video on SQL tips and tricks. Hope you have enjoyed it. Now with some care and creativity, you should be able to create some shortcuts in your development recipes. That will be all for today, but please join us next time for more OutSystems tutorials.